Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Wen. Here is the question. Is this function a probability density function? Sure, it is. It is a normal density function, standardized. Can you prove it? How to prove it? A density function must be a function which is non-negative and the integral should be equal to 1. Given function, f is here. We can see f is non-negative because that's exponential here. And we want to prove the integral from negative infinity to positive infinity equals 1. This is what we need to prove. We define a new integral. Just drop the constants here. If we drop the constants, we only need to show this I equals square root of 2 pi. From this equation, we can see that both sides times the square root of 2 pi, this side, this constant disappeared. That side, we have a square root of 2 pi. This side is our I. So the question is, can you prove I equals square root of 2 pi? How? Here is the method. We define I squared. We have the definition of I. I squared means I times I. Here, we use two different variables here. The first one use x for this integral. Second one use y for this integral. The purpose is to convert the original one variable integral into two variable double integral. We merge the two together and rewrite I square as a double integral. Here we have x squared plus y squared here. Now we use the polar system to find the double integral. That means we change the variable from the xy coordinates to the polar coordinates. That's the basic definition for the polar system. X equals r times sine theta, y equals r times sine theta. This x equals r times cosine theta. R equals square root of x squared plus y squared. That's the hypotenuse. We need to use the change of variables formula for double integral to solve our question. Based on that formula, we need to figure out what is the Jacobian of this transformation of variable. This is definition for Jacobian. Derivative of x with respect to r, derivative of x with respect to theta, same thing here for y equals this is the determinant. We can simply find the determinant. That's first part, that's cosine theta times r cosine theta equals r cosine theta square minus sine times r times sine. That's here's minus, the minus, that's plus. R times sine theta squared. Fact, the little r outside, inside part. The inside part is 1. cosine squared plus cosine sine squared equals what? Equals R. It's bigger than zero. Now we need to consider the range. The range for original X and Y both are from negative infinity to positive infinity. The range for the new variable, theta, the complete circle, is from 0 to 2 pi. That's a polar system. R is from 0 to positive infinity. We use the change of variables formula for double integrals. I squared. This is a formula. So here, we already defined little r equals square root of x squared plus y squared. Without square root, that's r squared. So here we have to add a factor of absolute value of Jacobian. That's a d theta dr. That's a formula. What is j here? That's r. Plug in. We are here. Look at the inside part, d theta. Inside part has nothing to do with theta. So just 2 pi, from 0 to 2 pi, that's a constant. And consider this integral from 0 to infinity with respect to little r. We can put the little r back to d inside. That's d r squared over 2. From here, if you cannot see it, you can define the new variable like t equals r squared over 2. If you can see it, that's one variable. So that's e to the power negative. So here, the antiderivative, that's negative e to the power negative r squared over 2. It's from 0 to positive infinity. Plug in positive infinity, this part equals 0. Plug in 0 here, this part is 1. E to the power 0, that's 1. Minus 1. Originally, you have negative. Negative minus 1 is positive. Positive 1 equals 2 pi. What we have done? We have done r squared equals 2 pi. What do we want? We want to prove I equals square root of 2 pi. Here we have the result for R square, for I squared. Take the square root on both sides. We have this result. We have done this. This is the proof. In general, we can prove the following. This is a general density function for normal distribution with mean mu and the variance sigma squared. It's a similar idea. Actually use this idea, replace the variable here, the whole thing here, change the variable. We will easily get the result. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.